I guess that was kind of the folksy version. Right, so She Says was next. I put it as track number 7 because I felt like there was always something kind of magical about track number 7.
Table 7!
Oh Jesus, what did I do to myself? Anyway, yeah, she says track number 7. It was also on Australia. It was a shoe in the door, a foot in the door for me. I was quite young. I was 19, 20. I started going around all these record labels and had meetings with all these people. And I was just young enough that I didn't really know how big of a deal it was, you know? I mean, I kind of knew, but I also thought I was pretty great because I was, you know, I was like 20. And, I don't know, maybe you can relate with that. It was mostly that I was naive and I had no idea. But anyway, I had a meeting in New York at one point with Clive Davis, who's kind of a legend. And he wanted to sign me, I think, to whatever he was working on at the time. And I have no idea why this happened, but I ended up going to this meeting by myself. No music attorney, no manager, no agent, just me showing up to meet Clive Davis. So I went up to the 737th floor of the building and waited a bit and then went into his office, and it was, I don't mean to be kind of mean, but I felt like it was a bit Dr. Evil-ish or something. It was kind of, I think it was because I suddenly became a bit intimidated by the whole thing. And I think it was supposed to be, because that's the whole game. But he didn't have a cigar, so there was that. But, I got to stop talking so long. But so he had all the lyrics to She Says printed out. He had his, you know, somebody do it for him. And he looks at me and he goes, "So Howie, I really like this song, She Says." And I was like, "Cool, man, thanks, yeah, cool." "Yeah, I'm just a groovy guy from Maine, whatever." And then he goes, "So," and then he's going, "She says she wants somebody else. I hope you know she doesn't mean you." He's like, "So who's the third person in this song?" Of course, I had no idea. And so that didn't go well. There's no punchline to that. I just had no idea. I think I made up something. So I don't know. But to this day, I don't really know that I know the answer to that question. I like the ambiguity of the lyric. So we should start a poll or something later, you know. You guys get crazy on Friday nights in New Hampshire. You got to do it early too. Do your bars close early as well here? Oh yeah, the bars in Maine close at like 8. So I had to move away when I was younger.
Except for the big sleazy.
No, deal breaker. But anyway. Anyway, so here She Says. Dedicated to the 10 of you who clapped for it. It's all right. It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. This is where the wheels come off on the show. About an hour and a half in, everything falls apart. Today,
That's why I'm wondering why you had to tell me what's going on in your head, what's wrong. Come around to another time when you don't have to run. And when she says she wants somebody else to help you now, she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down and makes a sound, you never hear her the way I do. Swinging to fly over hills, over her hills, it's twilight. Yeah, I guess it's right now. And while we're here, tell me why it's so funny that you're so funny when you're mad. Always so mad, so mad. And that's why I'm wondering why you had to tell me what's going on in your head, what's wrong. Come around to another time when you don't have to. Hope you know she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down and makes a sound, you'll never hear her the way I do. And when she says she wants someone to love, I hope you know she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down, lets you down, I hope you know she doesn't mean to. Yeah, yeah.